Hello everybody, good evening and welcome to tonight's webcast from Northampton, Blackstar's HQ. I'm Steve, the product trainer with Blackstar, and tonight we've got some stuff to show you with the ID series, mainly the ID 260 which I have here, and also we've got an ID core set up. Now what we're going to look at tonight is there's been a recent firmware and software update for the Insider software. And the firmware on the amplifier has been turned into super wide stereo capabilities. Now, if you don't know what that is, earlier on this year, we released a product called ID Core, which is behind me here. It was a small range of amplifiers, and there was three in the range, and they featured super wide stereo. Now, if that sounds like a little bit of a gimmick and you've not tried these, you need to get into your stores to try them. They sound amazing. They give you the essence that you're surrounded by the effects and the delays and the reverbs, almost as if you're in a stadium. And for such a small, inexpensive product, it really sets a new bar for home practice amplifiers. Recently, we did hear of a very, very popular guitar hero actually purchasing one of the ID Cores for his tour on the bus, just to jam with, to play music through. The speakers are stereo. So each amplifier has two speakers and it's full range flat response, so it sounds great for audio. And we'll look at that in a bit. So the ID range, which is the bigger brother and the more professional digital range that we do, consists of a 15 watt, a 30 watt, right up to the 60 watts, the 2x12, 260 here, and then we have a 60 head and a 100 head as well, which is more for the live application. Now, the ID series didn't have super wide stereo, but recently, because of the reaction to that 3D type sound and everybody blowing their minds around the world, the guys here at Blackstar have been very, very clever and working very hard to achieve it in these amps. Now, I must stress, the only amplifier physically that has the capabilities of super wide stereo in person, when you try it, when you gig with it, is the ID 2x12, the ID 260. The other amplifiers do have the super wide stereo facility, but it's only available from the USB output for recording or the emulated line out for direct recording or direct into a mixer. So you do have those capabilities there even on the 15 watt, which is amazing. Now, I've set up about four patches on here, so I'm going to do a little bit of playing. And it really is a very inspirational sound. I've been, obviously for my job, product training, I watch a lot of online videos and YouTube clips and gear rundowns from artists and some of my favourite guitarists myself, like you guys and girls. But more recently I've seen stuff where people are talking a lot about the digital side of things. And that can be quite expensive for the working musician. Not all of us have got thousands and thousands of pounds to spend on that kind of gear. But the ID series is in that same ballpark. You can profile the amplifiers if you know their history. For example, if you're not familiar with the amps, we've got six power tubes to choose from, and we've got six voices. And using Blackstar's patent ISF feature, where you can shape the American or British tone stack, you can really create anything from history if you know the valve that was in there. And the six power tubes that are on there, the choices are the most used, most obvious. Things like 6L6, EL84, EL34, even some intricate stuff like 6V6 and KT66, which you don't see that much of these days. But it's a really interesting prospect to be able to go out to a gig. You can use a MIDI controller on these, so it's a pro in that sense. But also we do an FS10 foot switch, which you can use, which is an optional extra, but which is quite inexpensive. And you can have all your presets on the floor, a chromatic tuner. You can store on the fly as well while you're at a show, and you can change banks and patches as you would expect. So I've got patches 1 to 4 set up. So let's just play around with my first patch. And what I've done here is just get quite a nice clean tone, but quite ambient, just to play around with some blues and some slow picking and stuff. Now, you can probably hopefully see we've got a couple of mics in front of the ID 260 here, and that's picking up the super wide stereo sound. So for best results, if you're watching on YouTube at a later point, welcome. If you're watching live now, maybe use some headphones or crank those stereo monitors if you're using them, which will give you the best experience. So let's do some playing. And this is a rather nice clean tone. Here. Sound very inspirational to play around with that, and just being next to the amplifier really feels like you're in the stadium atmosphere. It surrounds you. The effects don't sound like they're coming from the two cones, if you will. And it really, the amplifier is such a beautiful thing to play. It's very transparent, very natural. If I just play softly. It really reacts to the way you feel, you know, if you want to play harder, it really comes through that way. So on to another sound. This is my second patch, which is a very kind of similar tone as far as effects go, but I've added some delay, and this is really where the super wide stereo comes into effect the most, I think. So for now, I'm just going to just mute my reverb for the moment, so all you can hear is the delay, and hopefully you'll get that really nice super wide stereo sound. Turn the reverb off then, so. Minimal in the mix. Really, it's astonishing. You need to hear this, so get into your stores and try them. So let's just add the reverb back. Added a little bit more gain, and it kind of put me in mind of a very subtle kind of Jeff Beck sound, which inspired me a few weeks ago just to try and learn that style. Nobody's ever going to get close to Jeff, of course, but that kind of subtle overdrive with some nice ambient stuff going on. Nice inspirational tone there, just to work around with that Jeff Beck feel. Mistakes are free, remember, especially when it's live like this. But you know, you get that really nice. Percussive sound, very useful. The next sound I've done, let's see. That's right, a really nice kind of multi-tap delay. So to get that really nice kind of... really useful kind of the edge style sound, but you can get some really nice kind of... If you play at the same time as a lick that will fit the tempo, you can get some really interesting things going on there. But having that super wide stereo included is just... astonishing for feel as a guitarist, you know. Quite cool. The fourth patch I've done is more of a kind of garage style punk sound. So I've used a room reverb. It really, even in such a small studio room like this, it really feels like you're in a garage. So it sounds great for that old school kind of. Really cool, man. It's a great punk sound. And same rules apply as everything else you've probably seen on the net about ID series. You can store up to 128 presets. That means 128 profiles of your favorite amps. amps that you design as well. For example, you could have a really high gain sound with a very, very compressed 6V6 power tube that would normally only appear in a small American combo. So you can really get some versatile things going on and really create the sound in your head that you're after for the recording or the live show. More recently, I've gone on to the Insider community and created some newer patches. I did a whole bunch of patches that are up there. And if you search for Blackstar Product Trainer, you should find all of my patches. And they've had thousands of downloads, which is really, really cool. And there's all sorts of stuff on there. But more recently, I've looked a little bit closer to some of our endorsees who have used our gear and are using Blackstar live. And they've used it in the past. And it was really an interesting journey to kind of look into some of the biggest hits and their songs and just get the lick down, try and match the amplifier that they would have been using and get that kind of tone. And it's worked really, really well. It was quite a nice journey. I'm just going to show you a few now and scroll through on the laptop here. Just bear with me a second and I'll see what crops up. So we've got something like the very, very cool cat, Mr. Huey Morgan. I hope you're watching, brother.
Hey, hey.
So I've done like a patch called Fun Loving Criminals, if you want to search for it. This is the vibe I was going for. So bear with me a second. I'm just going to get my FS10 into effects mode. And this will allow me to turn the tremolo that I've set on the patch on and off. So if I just play... tremolo added, but simply I can just turn it off like that. It's a really, really nice tremolo. Here's the track, see if you recognize it. Cigar in there as well, if you want. You know the song. Let's look at some other stuff we've done. So, Steve Craddock, good old Steve Craddock, a fellow Brummie like myself. I've called the patch Ocean Colour Scene. Steve's a massive fan and used Artisan for a long, long time with Weller as well. But a really nice big EL84 tone. So you get that real feel of that classic Ocean Colour Scene sound, you know? That's kind of cool. I was happy with that one. Let's see what else we've got here. Okay. Richie Sambora, 80s guitar hero. I've called it Sambora When Wet, so it really looks at that kind of 80s, 90s period of Sambora's tone. Really big delay there to kind of carry those big guitar solos through. What else we got here? Tesla, Mr. Frank Hannon. Again, another kind of 80s guy, but a real nice, subtle Series 1 type sound that he's currently using with Tesla. Enough to back it off and do some clean. Great tone. I saw those guys at Download 2014, and that was a really cool moment because I loved the band years ago. But that really big 80s kind of rock smooth distortion. Mr. Gaz Coombs from Supergrass. If I remember the lick, a couple of weeks ago I did these patches, so I learned the licks at the time. But We Are Young, We Are Free, that kind of sound. But check them out. There's tons of stuff on there that I've recently uploaded. So just look for Blackstar Product Trainer, or look for those some of those patches I've just mentioned, and you'll find me there. But there's some really interesting tones, and they're all free, of course. The Insider software lets you have a login on the online community, and you can share and download patches for free, as well as download official artist patches as well. For example, let me show you something that I downloaded from Mr. Tommy Henriksen, who's Alice Cooper's guitar player, as well as the lovely Nita. But this is kind of one that for School's Out he's done. So it works, you know? And I downloaded that, learnt the lick, the intro lick anyway, and it was there. So yeah, make sure you check them out. And please be aware that all the amplifiers that we have do constantly need to be looked at as regards firmware and software updates. If you go into a store tomorrow and I haven't got there yet, I can't be everywhere at the same time and haven't updated the amp, you might try an ID260 and it might not quite be super wide stereo yet. So that's important for you guys to know as well. And I'll try and get everywhere I can in the UK especially. And if any staff guys are watching, any guys that work in stores, make sure you get inside or on a laptop in the store, on your own laptop, and make sure the amps are up to date, because it's really important to get those features across to people, because it really is a new level. This amplifier was fantastic before, it's even more fantastic now with the super wide stereo feature. Okay, so let's look at changing down the patch. So let me just show you briefly the FS10. Really sturdy unit, very very cheap for a night. For the cost of a night out, less than a night out, you can get a really sturdy solid pedal to use with your ID series. You can use a MIDI board as well, as I mentioned earlier, connected by a single jack to the rear of the amp. This will give you your patch mode, chromatic tuner, all the rest of the stuff we discussed earlier. Very cool. Okay, so on to the ID series, the core. You can probably see we've got my iPad here. Now, you can download an application on the iPad called GarageBand. You've probably heard of it, more than likely. If you pay for the full version, which I think is around about £5 in British sterling, you get all the really clever smart instruments. So you get things like smart guitar, smart bass, smart drums, importantly. So you get a whole ton of drums to choose from, and you can simply select a kit that you like the sound of, roll the dice, and it will give you some different styles, and you can copy and paste those parts, do some fills, and you can instantly get a very, very quick drum pattern to record with. Now, recently we did an experiment here at Blackstar by using the camera connection kit, which gives the iPad a USB. So my iPad at the moment has got the lightning connection into the USB out there, which I've connected into the ID amplifier. So that's as easy as that is. We're currently using the emulated line out as well, which will be the headphones out, just so you guys get a really good imagery of the sound of what's going on. So if I just open GarageBand, I've already preloaded a drum track, which I'll show you briefly. Hopefully we'll get some level. Yes, that is coming from this small amplifier, that sound. They're amazing. You gotta check them out. And this is where Super Wide Stereo was born. And now it's in the big brother. So I've selected a brief, small drum pattern. And this evening, we're going to attempt to just jam over it and try and record something. I've got a couple of ideas that I wanna lay down. So we'll see how it goes. But it's only a small segment. So let me just show you the drum sound that I chose just to jam along with. Nice and easy. Just a standard kind of rock rhythm, if you like. I'm going to choose one of my presets. You can store up to 6 presets on ID Core. I've got a really nice kind of ambient ambient sound there. So I'm going to record with that first, I think. Idea. So we need to select a new recording track, which I'm going to do now. Okay, bear with me a moment. Audio recorder, I'm going to select it to stereo, so we get the full range of the amp. And then we're ready to go. So I'm just going to track something, see what happens. Okay, that went pretty well. Just a little idea that I had. So let's make sure it's down and we're happy with it. And this is how easy it is to just listen back through your core amp. With that, I'm going to choose a different preset now, something with a little bit more crunch. Okay. So we need to select another track now, which is nice and easy. Just open up another audio recorder. Again, select stereo. Okay. So I've got my tone ready, now we're going to record along. Okay, so I was happy with that, just a couple of chord changes. Now I'm going to play something over the top, hopefully a bit of a lead break, and we'll see what we can come up with. So again, we need to add a new track. This is all coming through the ID Core GarageBand. Remember, GarageBand's only around about £5. Less than some fish and chips. And the ID Core is very inexpensive for a small practice amp, but the super wide stereo, the recording facilities, the insider software, start to think about that and how much, you know, you get a lot for your money. Okay, so again, select stereo, so you want to hear how good the amp sounds. And let's get a tone. So I'm happy with that, and we'll see what we can come up with lead-wise. So let's listen to a full mix. That was good enough. Good enough for rock and roll. And we can get all the track up and let's see how it sounds, what we've recorded in the moment tonight. Okay, so I don't know about that last bit, but certainly the rest sounded pretty musical to me, and it was just a little idea I put down. So this is capable, you know, at a very, very low cost to get some demos down and some ideas. So look into it. It's a really, really great bit of fun to have. So that's really it for this evening. Thank you very much for tuning in. And if you're watching on YouTube at a later point, remember to follow us on all the usual social media channels. Subscribe to the YouTube channel to find out all up-to-date information. Twitter, Facebook, Instagram, and all the usual things. If you need any help, any further advice as regarding Blackstar amps, whether it's our HT range of pedals, right through to Artisan, you can email me on steve.marks@blackstaramps.com. And also, if you want just a general inquiry, it's inquiries@blackstaramps.com. So we're going to leave you with a really new exclusive product that is coming out for November, and you don't need to be a guitarist to benefit from it. So I'll leave you with that. And we'll see you next time. Thank you very much for watching. Keep it loud, keep using amplifiers, and write some new music and bring new bands out and keep rocking and rolling. Cheers. Thank you.